goes, "Stop, stop, be there." And they didn't want to be there. And he goes, "Yes." Suddenly, the rain stopped and a complete double rim appeared over the sea. And they felt that this was a special sign that they were going to touch this. The rest, as they say, is history. We can see it. We will never know. And who sailed on it? Could have been the disciples. Could have been Jesus. It could have been just a plain fisherman that we don't know anything about. But it's still here to give us a bit of history. And just in the case that's over behind us is the cooking pot and the oil lamp that they found in the boat. Because the boat was abandoned and simply sank in the mud by the shore. The mud is what protected and blocked out the oxygen so we could find what we have today. Now the young boys, they were then young boys, who found the original nails, and those nails are in there too, didn't tell anybody about it for 2 weeks. And I asked him, why didn't you do it? He said, "I didn't have to, it was my treasure. I didn't need to tell anybody about it." But after 2 weeks, they told their dad, and they came down to look, and that's when the world turned upside down. And though on the outside, to please everybody in the boat, is called the ancient Galilean boat. All of my groups still call it the Jesus boat. Questions? If not, I'll get you some cards. You can come into the gift shop and enjoy the gift shop. And if somebody says, "We're going to lunch, right?" Okay, we're not waiting until 2 o'clock. I'd like to be able to use the